Let's create a vector of this style. So we start with 0 and then increase it by steps of 0.1 and run it up to 6. Yeah, so remember, this was our start point, this is our end point, and that's our step width. So now let's do the following and feed this into a sine function and let's see what happens. So remember, if you were doing this in C, this won't work. You cannot feed a vector into a function, but let's do this now here in MATLAB, 0.1 and up to 6. So we've got our values here. So now let's process this vector x in our sine function. And now the surprising result is that there's no error message. So if we're now looking at y, we see that we are getting the same amount of values back. So we see that MATLAB has basically processed all these values here one by one and generated new values out here. So this means MATLAB is processing the vector element by element. So processing is element by element. Processing element by element. So that's important. So basically with this way of processing, we are avoiding loops. So or we are implicitly generating a loop. So this is an implicit loop. We don't need to do here in MATLAB. This is automatically done just by processing every element step by step.